This is our 100th electric guitar playthrough cover video that we have uploaded here at Worship Tutorials. So we wanted to do something special for this one, Bradford and I. So we chose a throwback of sorts and kind of put our own spin on it. But we also wanted to give away these patches to you for free just to celebrate sort of that number milestone that we just hit. So links below where you can download this song patch for Revelation Song, for Axe-FX III, for FM3, and for Helix. You can use them on any song. You don't have to use it just on Revelation Song, but if you're playing this song in your church, just got a free patch for it. Here's Bradford to tell you a little bit more about how we approach building this patch.
Hey everyone, thanks for checking out this video. This is the third in the last few weeks that we've released, third playthrough we've released in a while. It's a lot more of an older song, and we just kind of felt like the songs we're choosing are songs that we're seeing people constantly and regularly bring up, so that they're still doing at their churches. And so that's part of the reason why we're doing this. But also, Revelation Song is just so cool. The lyrics in and of themselves are just so good, because it's a lot of it's talking about the throne room of God in Revelation, which, you know, as the name suggests, Revelation Song. But that's what we're going to be singing. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. So as often as we will be singing that phrase, is as many versions of the song that there is. A lot of different artists have covered this or have done their rendition of it. Jennie Lee Riddle is the original writer of the song. There's, if you know, Don Moen, Phillips Craig and Dean, Kari Jobe. The version we did was Kari Jobe leading a passion version. And there's others. There are others. But we played to the passion version and kind of created a patch that was a little more broad strokes purposes. The sounds here, because we're using the Axe effects in this one, we can get a little more fun. We have bigger verbs for swells and the ambient clean. Those are our first two snaps, the first two scenes, depending on what unit you're using. You heard swells at the beginning. Then you heard me switch to the ambient clean a little bit, switch to the rhythm, which the rhythm just has a king of tone on it, just give it a little extra. There's a rhythm plus slash turn, we use that a couple times, and so that's got the amp gain and the king of tone. And then the solo has the bigger verb with the full drive and the amp gain. And later on in the song, I just kind of went rogue and started stacking drives because I wanted more. So five total scenes, five snapshots, that's what we're using. Again, swells, ambient clean, rhythm, rhythm plus slash turn. I kind of use it for like the first little, not quite as huge solo. And then also there's a solo button with a lot more verb and all. Whether you are using Axe-FX, FM3, or Helix, you're going to get a very similar layout, very similar sounds. We've gotten to the point where Brian and I can kind of create or coax, is that the word, Brian? Either unit to sound similar. Nobody is sacrificing anything by trying to make the other one sound like the other one. So maybe there'll be a Helix video at some point, but if you're listening to this and you're a Helix user, just know that you can expect pretty much the same thing. FM3, though, obviously, it's gonna sound quite similar. We used the Mattress DC30, by the way. Such a good amp, and the Silver Sky, because why not? Great strat tones, great lead sounds. So thanks for checking this out. We hope you enjoyed it. If you are looking for the patches, links are down in the description. And if you got an older song, and by older, I mean like this one's like at least 20 years old, I think. It's pretty close. It may be early 2000s. It may not be quite 20 years old yet. But if you got a song, older song, let's say at least 10 years old that we haven't covered, let us know and we'll do it, maybe. We'd like to kind of to see what y'all are doing, what kind of songs. Maybe you got a song in your church that is considered old, but your church loves it and you do it all the time.
Or you just introduced it last week.
Or you just introduced it last week.
It's brand new.
And it's brand new to you all, but it's 10 plus years old. Either way, just let us know. We'll see what happens. Thanks for joining us. We will see you in the next one.